People sentenced in the 80s, 2000s. What modern world change shocked you the most? Anthony Ray Hinton described people walking around looking at down these things in their hands, phones, and amazingly not bumping into each other. Now, on the day you were released, your best friend, Lester, who had visited you every single week for nearly 30 years, picked you up. You'd been behind bars since 1985. So you got in his car, and what was the first thing you wanted to do? Right hand, Lester thought, I'd want to get something decent to eat. But I wanted to go where they laid my mother's body. I see him messing with the radio dial, then we start driving down the road. I heard this little white lady say, in 1/10 of a mile, turn right. I jumped and said, what the hell? Bow, you thought there was a white lady in the car? Right hand, yes, and Lester's laughing so hard he has to pull over. He says, that's a GPS. When he explained what it does, it really hit me how long I'd been locked up. The world had changed. Got a call from a woman filing a claim on some abandoned funds. I got all her information, and then asked for an email address, and she said, what's email? I keep hearing about it, but you gotta understand I've been in prison a long time. I remember getting the bus years ago, and this old bloke got on heading away from town center towards the more residential areas. Without a second thought he sparked up a cigar. One of the passengers told him you can't smoke on a bus. He apologized and quickly stubbed it out, but said he got discharged from prison that day, and when he went in you could smoke anywhere you wanted, so this was a massive culture shock to him. Prisoner transfer. I did one time for this man who was sentenced to life in 1968, and it's the first time he'd driven past the CN Tower in Toronto, and he couldn't believe how tall it was. That and he was blown away by how many different car brands there were. My cousin's husband, that she married, while he was serving 10 years beginning around 2008, wanted the first thing he did as a free man was to go to Hollywood Video, and rent movies to watch with her. Then she blew his mind with Netflix. At least the idea of Netflix and chill wasn't far from his original plan, but he was shocked about there not being video stores anymore. My friend's older brother was jailed in 1994, and served 15 years. He said when he went in, anyone with an in-car phone was super rich, and to then see absolutely everyone have a completely cordless pocket-sized phone, was amazing. He also said, that all the TV adverts, had websites to visit, or were for completely online stores, which were a bit of an alien concept, as he'd never really seen or used the internet. He also found the chip and pin process of paying for things on a bank card extremely exciting. Knew a guy who was blown away by digital cameras. He had purchased an old terrible one and couldn't get over how amazing it was. A friend said his dad's friend tried VR after about 30 years in prison for like second degree murder or something, and he got scared, fell over and broke the headset. I was talking to a lady who runs the education for a federal prison in Florida. She said when they start getting rambunctious or off topic, she mentions a new feature of the newest iPhone and all of a sudden they're very interested in what she has to say again. Obligatory, not me, but in the early 2000s I worked with a guy that was sentenced in the mid 80s and had just come out. He told me the first time he went to a men's room he spent several minutes looking for the handle to flush. Motion sensor toilets was completely alien to him. Not me personally, but we had an older guy rent out a room in our house a few years back. Usually we rented it out to students, but someone let us know that he had just moved to our city and needed something temporary until he found permanent accommodation. It was a bit frustrating because this guy would not use the internet to search for a car or place to live. Didn't know how it worked and didn't trust it. We tried to help him learn how, because we thought he was just old and stubbornly resisted technology, but nope. Turns out that he had spent 11.5 years in maximum security prison after being framed by WAR police for murder in the mid-90s. Came out with trust issues and a dislike for the backquote new internet. A co-worker a few years ago had spent 10 years in jail. He got out right when Bluetooth headsets for phones were huge. He'd talk about all the random conversations he thought people were trying to have with him, and smartphones freaked him the hell out. I hired a guy that was released after 17 years, circa 2005. A week after he started working he bought a phone. He had a childlike wonder with push-to-talk and texting. A week later he was pissed off that he couldn't text his order into Hungry Howie's. Not my personal experience, but a man I worked with, after he was released from prison, after being sentenced as a young adult, was blown away by the touchscreen ordering at Walla, and could not fathom why the employees could not take an oral order from him. I never give money to beggars, because in Dallas, TX, I've been told the same story by the same ones time and time again. However, there was one who was fresh out of prison and seemingly honest with me, because there was no sob story, just a guy trying to get fucked up, around 2013-ish. He came up to me and said, and I quote, "My oh, and I just got out of prison. Been in there since 97. All these people walking around with cameras and their phones trips me the fuck out. Anyway, this fool over here says I can smoke this fat ass joint with him if I bring $2. Can you help me out?" His honesty and comedic timing slash train of thought made me laugh. That's the only stranger I've ever happily given money to. No longer having to go to a friend's house to play video games together. And the fact that everyone has cell phones now means you don't have to go to a friend's house and hope they're home. Also, computers. Everyone has some sort of computer in their home, or access to one. I remember being told that I needed to learn cursive, because all your papers are done in blue or black ink in cursive once you get to high school. My mom taught me cursive in first, and I never ended up using it, because my school started teaching us how to type in third grade. By the time I reached middle school, we were turning in typed papers. What happened with Legos? They used to be simple. Oh come on, I know you know what I'm talking about. Legos were simple. Something happened out here, while I was inside. Harry Potter Legos, Star Wars Legos, complicated kits, tiny little blocks. I mean, I'm not saying it's bad, I just wanna know what happened. There was that documentary of someone who was sentenced in the 70s, Otis I think, and he just couldn't believe the stuff he was seeing, since he lived in New York, with all the screens it was just a different city than all the different colored drinks and people wearing earphones, like they were in the Secret Service. It's an interesting thing to watch. My friend just came home 2 weeks ago, and I tried to prepare him the best I knew how for the excessive use of cell phones by everyone. I explained that he's going to be amazed by the amount of people glued to slash looking at their phone 24/7 in the store, in the car, on the sidewalk, sitting in the house watching TV, like literally all the time. I also let him know that the technology is going to be really different, since he went in over 13 years ago, so cell phones were still flip phones and definitely not as interactive, touch screens, and internet accessible. Needless to say, the second day home he called me angry as fuck. Lol, he hated how he felt stupid, and how he felt like a child, because he could barely figure out how to call someone, let alone video chat slash FaceTime. At one point he couldn't figure out how our phone call ended up on the radio, when his friend turned on the car. _ He didn't like having his kids teach him how to use the technology and just was getting really discouraged. Basically, reiterating the feeling stupid mentality. I just tried to reassure him that when we all were exposed to this technology, we had to learn it. And many people forget what it was like to not know how to use something like a smartphone. We take for granted how we learned something and how we were once new to a process. Today it seems he's being more patient with himself, but it is a daily struggle, and one I try to be positive and kind to him so he knows, if no one else, at least he can rely on slash call on me to just listen to him vent. At college, I bumped into a guy at a bus stop who did 20 years and had just gotten out the previous week. He struck up the conversation by talking about cell phones and how it was that we could talk with anyone by staring at a computer we could fit in our pocket. The concept baffled him. I had to explain the concept of why texting can be easier than calling. He told me that the thing that surprised him most, however, was how awful it was to watch the news. He hadn't been able to watch TV behind bars, and so was amazed and disappointed at how partisan and ridiculous news shows had become. In a world where the prison system actually made sense, this thread should be empty. The role of a prison shouldn't be punishment, it should be reintegration into society. Taking someone away for 30 years and throwing him back is the absolute antithesis of reintegration. I asked a friend what the hardest thing was for him readjusting to being free again, This is a roundabout of what he said. Closing doors. I'd leave the fridge open every time without fail for months. You're not allowed to open or shut anything for yourself. And I'd accidentally let the pets outside. By forgetting I needed to close the front door someone else had opened in front of me. You forget the last one in Rule ECT and have to learn it all again. What was the thing you found you liked the most? Candy Crush. Gets phone back out and starts playing. 5 minutes later exclaim they've leveled up excitedly. So sweet. My dad once hired a dude who just got out of prison to work with him for a day. He got in somewhere in the late 80s and was released early 10s. It was like 2 months after he got out, and my dad said jokingly told him, I bet you were surprised when you heard about Michael Jackson. He said yeah, his death was a real tragedy. My dad said no, the kid diddling thing. My dad said he never saw such shock on a person when he showed him the articles. I remember helping a guy who went in 2005, got released 2014, had a black and green AudioVox phone in his effects, and asked where he could activate it. I had to explain that it wouldn't be happening lol. Like 3 months later, ick now, I like the iPhone, but I'm gonna wait for the release of the newest one. Adapted pretty quick. The lack of non-mobile phones probably. I remember thinking a car phone was the biggest leap ever as a kid. We had one in a second-hand Oldsmobile, but the monthly bill was so high that it was never working. But we had a phone in the car. Blew my 6-year-old brain. My dad would always tell me stories, like how he got out, walked into Walmart, and ended up crying because he didn't have to ask to use the restroom. A couple other family members did really long time and couldn't use the bathroom without asking permission. I remember him trying to flip a CD upside down and put it back into the CD player, like you would do with a record, because it was skipping. Didn't notice how much of a big deal that must have been to him at the time. Adjusting to life on the outside can be really tough. A friend's dad said he couldn't believe how crude and boisterous women have become. He went to town for a night out drinking, and he said something like they were shouting, swearing, and throwing up in the street. He tried to talk to a group of girls who replied with fuck off granddad. He also can't get his head around the amount of people taking photos of themselves. This is in the UK BTW. I remember a story from Pakistan. A pregnant lady was convicted and she gave birth while in prison. Due to the corruption and broken law, the baby was also in prison until he was freed by a social worker who works for prison justice or something. By the time he was released, he was already in his teens, I believe, and he was just shocked to see what the real world was. He didn't even understand the concept of waiting for the cars to stop before crossing the road. Sorry for my English. I heard a guy talking about this who was sentenced in the 70s and got out in maybe 2015. One thing was, he thought everyone was walking around talking to themselves. Then someone explained to him that they were talking the phone with the little things in their ears. The other was that he got up to give his seat to a much younger woman on the subway and she argued with him and wouldn't take the seat when he insisted. I think eventually she did, but it upset the guy that women wouldn't take a seat when he offered, even though he was pretty old and gray by this point. My first job, I worked with this guy who went to prison for a long time. I think he was on parole at the time. Dude made some pretty messed up choices, selling heroin and coke. I think he threatened to murder his ex-wife. Anyway, this was around 2012, and we chatted often. When the radio played in the store, he would only sing the songs from the 90s. I always thought it was because he liked that music the most. Nope, that was the last music he heard before going to prison 4 years. He didn't know what Google was. He didn't know YouTube. What's a Facebook? Never heard of Twitter. He barely knew how to operate the internet at all. It was so shocking to me to meet someone who was much older than me. I wanna say late 30s, early 40s, and not know these things. Anytime I hear Hootie and the Blowfish or Blues Traveler, I always see his face in my mind, just singing along. He had a really good attitude with things. He really wanted to put himself on the right track, and I hope he did. I wonder what happened to him. He always had something funny to say about something. Good sense of humor. I really hope he got his life together and is somewhere good. And that he's found out that YouTube is a gold mine for cat videos.